You know, friends are selected, but community is given. You know, there's also this idea in our world right now that when someone hurts you, cut them off and get rid of the toxicity in your life. But if that person has the Holy Spirit inside of them, and you just so quickly want to cut them off, that is absolutely toxic to the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is grieved. It mourns because part of itself, himself, is being torn apart, and there's not unity, and that grieves the Holy Spirit. We don't cut people off. We fight to restore. We fight to build. That's how we're a light to the world. Like 1 Corinthians 3, it says we don't destroy the temple. We don't criticize. We don't just look and point. We see ourselves as equal members that have a role to play in building together the dream that God has. You know, there's this idea sometimes in our world that I have friends in the church. I don't need a small group. I don't need a community group. I've got some friends. And sometimes what happens when we only surround ourselves with the friends that enjoy us is we actually don't become more like God. Because we don't learn how to work with people that have hurt us or that are different than us or that think differently than us. You know, that person that you're struggling with right now, do you believe that they have the Holy Spirit inside of them? If you do, then you should be fighting for peace, fighting to get resolved. It's not just about a few people. You know, if this is true, then no part of the temple can function on its own. You don't have a temple and then a few stones on the side. No matter how big, maybe you have a group of people, but if all of you guys have zero respect, zero appreciation for the church global, for the temple global, then you're not working in unison, building up the temple of God. The reality is that there's a lot of unity to be made and to be forged. I think about how hard it is to fight for unity. You have unity in your marriage, unity in your family, then you have unity with your friends, but then a small group. But then we don't want to just be small groups that function isolated, but we want to have maybe not as profound relationships as our community groups, but we want to have tethers to other community groups. We don't want to just be a church that is our own thing, but we want to be tethered and connected to churches around us. And that takes work and effort to appreciate that if this is true, the church in Paris is a part of the same temple. So we care about Paris. We care about the Bahamas. We care about Trinidad. We care about everywhere. We care about Athens. We care about every church here in the Southeast. Because it's the same temple and we're striving together. And I know that that's a conviction of this church. This belief that we have to be generous and give, and we've got a lot of building to do everywhere, not just here.